What ho, motherfuckers! My name is Mr. British Stereotype. Now, throughout my life, I've witnessed performances in the great medium of film that can be described as good, bad, ugly, and a special category that I like to call the category. So, join me on a magnificent adventure through the medium of film. Welcome to the Performance Review. Video, and I'm sure that in the future I will look upon it with utter disdain and regret. But let me tell you a bit about what all these shenanigans are all about. Basically, I take an actor or an actress famous, and I look at their career, their high points and their abominable low points. Anyways, joining me as always is Colonel Montgomery 12. Colonel?
What? Where are they? Where are they? Where the fuck are they? I'll kill them all, I tell ya! I'll kill them all!
Right. So, today's episode focuses on the walking blank slate that is Mr. Keanu Reeves. Let's have a look at his history, shall we? Keanu is Canadian, but was born in Beirut in Lebanon. His mother is English, and his father is American of Hawaiian, Portuguese, Chinese, and English descent. This makes his nationality basically terrifyingly hard to determine. It's kind of like a clusterfuck of nationalities, and supports the fact that he is indeed an alien. Also, Keanu in Hawaiian means the coldness. He is an alien, isn't he?
Can I stab him in the face?
No, Colonel, you cannot stab him in the face. So don't. Oh, come on! That was my good chair! Seriously? Ah, okay. Well, on a serious note, Keanu's life hasn't been all roses. His father left the family when Keanu was just 3. His sister was diagnosed with leukemia in the early 1990s. He went to 4 different high schools and was expelled from the last one. And his hockey career was cut short when he had an injury. I mean, to be honest, the dude's had a hard life. But he's a movie star now, so everything's fine. Well, enough of this misery and woe. Let's have a look at his high points, shall we? Keanu is one of the strangest enigmas in modern Hollywood. The guy truly tends to polarize people. I mean, is he a talented actor or is he just a lucky son of a bitch? Because there are some epic films in his filmography. Take the masterpiece that is Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure.
Whoa!
Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure was probably the first time we were introduced to Reeves as an actor. And he was awesome. He was charming, he was charismatic, and he was damn funny. But then things started to get a little weird. He was given the lead role in Point Break, an action film no less.
I love that movie better than cone syrup, and I fucking love cone syrup.
I'm scared of you. This was a brave choice. I mean, they took Theodore Logan and gave him a fucking gun. It's like taking Mike Myers and putting him in Die Hard. It doesn't make any sense. It feels so wrong. Yet it feels so right.
Thank you, San Dimas High!
Now as a film, Point Break holds up remarkably well, especially as an action film. But from that point onwards, Keanu Reeves would perfect the blank-faced action hero demeanor that he held throughout that film, and that would later plague his films. Or ultimately help them. I mean, I'm not completely sure if Reeves is truly a bad actor or not. Maybe he's just had some bad luck, because the guy played Hamlet, for goodness sake. And look at his filmography. There's Speed, The Gift, The Matrix, and my personal favourite performance from him, In a Scanner Darkly. A kind of rotoscoped animation, science fiction, clusterfuck of imagination. That's just pure awesomeness in my opinion.
Anyway. Substance D. D.
D is for dumbness and despair and desertion. The desertion of your friends from you, you from your friends. Everyone from everyone.
Isolation and loneliness and hating and suspecting each other. D is finally death. Slow death.
From the head down.
Well,
that's it.
Now, my personal favorite film of Keanu's has to be The Matrix. Not performance, but film. As a film, The Matrix, well, it's just that. It's The Matrix. It's one of the greatest films of the 1990s. But as for Reeves's performance, I mean, it is good, but maybe it's just bland. Maybe it's the right kind of bland. Let me explain. Originally, Will Smith was going to play Neo. Can you imagine that now? Will Smith as Neo? That's just ridiculous when you think about it. Neo isn't fun. He doesn't make wise cracks, or at least not particularly funny ones, and he certainly doesn't say, "Oh, hell nah."
Oh, hell no.
In fact, his acting is so subtle it may as well not even be there. I mean, I love The Matrix, it's one of my favourite films, but how can I love it if the main actor can't act for toffee? Or can he? I don't know. I have to make my mind up at some point, but I just don't know! I don't know! I don't know! Someone tell me! I don't know!
Well, how the heck should I know?
Colonel, I need help. I just don't know.
Lady Clara Verdevere, of me you shall not win renown. You thought to break a country heart, at pastime ere you went to town. At me you smiled, but unbeguiled. I saw the snare and I retired. The daughter of 100 elves, you are not one to be desired.
That doesn't help in the slightest! Okay, I've had enough. We're moving on to his low points, and by God, he's had some low points. Keanu foolishly only did one more comedy after Point Break, and that was Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey. I mean, it's a shame. The guy showed a real knack for it. Well, I say he only did one more comedy. He also did Johnny Mnemonic.
You know, all my life, I've been careful to stay in my own corner. Looking out for number one, no complications. Now, suddenly, I'm responsible for the entire fucking world. And everybody and his mother is trying to kill me. If my head doesn't blow up first. You see that city over there? That's where I'm supposed to be. Not down here with the dogs and the garbage and the fucking last month's newspapers blowing back and forth! I've had it with them! I've had it with you! I've had it with all this! I want room service!
Thank you.
I want the club sandwich. I want the cold Mexican beer. I want a $10,000 a night hooker.
So, Keanu Reeves wants a $10,000 a night hooker. How sweet.
I want my shirts laundered. Like they do at the Imperial Hotel. In Tokyo.
Now, to be honest, I haven't actually seen Johnny Mnemonic. Yay, sound effects. I just really, really don't want to. I mean, it just looks terrible. I don't think I can take that amount of gargantuan fuck in a movie. I'm not a sadist. Well, I know that you are, but you're just weird, fucktard. So, Keanu has undoubtedly committed a lot of crimes against cinema, such as The Watcher, The Day the Earth Stood Still, A Walk in the Clouds, and fucking Little Buddha. What was that about? But none of them are like his performance in the 1992 version of Dracula.
Budapest. Left Budapest early this morning. The impression I had was that we were leaving the west and entering the east. The district I am to enter is in the extreme east of the country, just on the borders of three states, Transylvania, Moldavia, and Bukovina, in the midst of the Carpathian Mountains, one of the wildest and least known portions of Europe.
Now, as an Englishman, I must say, I kind of feel offended and slightly sickened by that performance.
Budapest.
Well, in fact, as a human being who can make words with his mouth, I feel slightly offended. I mean, I'm not particularly sure what you were going for there, Keanu. No one speaks like that, especially not in England. God. Anyways, I digress. The flick Dracula was actually much better than Keanu Reeves' performance and made up for it with massive doses of Gary Oldman, which is usually a good thing. Well, in theory.
The ogre's butt.
But even though Keanu is terrible in the film, and make no mistake, he is awful, he's still strangely magnetic in the film. I mean, even when he's bad, at least he's entertaining. He's not just thoroughly bad, like Jessica Alba. Oh god. No, he's still entertaining. And that's what makes him a good actor to watch on screen. Anyways, next segment, please. Keanu's got a bunch of flicks in development, according to the all-knowing, all-powerful IMDb. Next on the cards is Henry's Crime, a comedy about
an aimless man who is sent to prison for a crime he did not commit.
Yay? I don't know, it sounds like the A-Team if no one got out of jail and it was just Murdoch. I mean, at least it's good he's doing comedy again. But what really draws my attention is the absolutely batshit insane products in the future. We've got Jekyll, which is an adaptation of the Jekyll and Hyde story you all know and presumably love, in which Reeves plays Jekyll and presumably Hyde. Ugh. Imagine Reeves trying to put that much emotion, turning into the monster that is Mr. Hyde. Poor dear. Having to put that much emotion into a character? He'll explode. Another hopefully false rumor is that Keanu has been cast as Cowboy Bebop in a film adaptation. And in one swift move, they have killed any credibility that the film adaptation had from the start. I mean, I guess Keanu could carry it off, maybe, but they had a choice of every actor in the entire universe, and they chose Neo. just doesn't make sense to me. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm stumped. I truly do not know whether Keanu Reeves is a good actor or not. It's strange. I mean, he's a decent actor in, say, Bill and Ted or A Scanner Darkly, and as far as I know, he's brilliant in Hamlet. But apart from that, I mean, every time I see a trailer for one of his films, I still get strangely drawn to it, knowing that he's gonna pull the same bland-faced, woe-saying shtick to the table. I still go. I waltz on down to the cinema. He confuses me. He's an enigma. A question. A mystery never to be solved. I don't know. I don't know.
Look into your black, miserable heart, Stereotype. You'll find the answer there.
After all this pondering, I think I finally know the answer. I think I love Keanu Reeves. Well, I think that about wraps things up. I have been Mr. British Stereotype. That has been Colonel Montgomery 12.
Ah, hey, squirrels!
And now, here comes the credits, to remind you of what I just told you. Even though I'm not particularly sure why internet review shows need credits, but here's some anyway. Because in reality, it's just one poor lonely person talking to a camera in the middle of the night, alone. Anyways, fuck off and die.
Seven out of ten on the awesome scale.
Another hopefully false rumor is that Keanu has been cast as Count there.